everybody, how are you? This is Dr. Susan Richards again. I love that we are both touching on inflammation because it is so foundational. It doesn't matter if you're watching us from Florida or Georgia or Texas or Colorado or Wisconsin, and maybe some of you have a flu and some of you have a cold and some of you have arthritis and some have high blood pressure, and there's people with cancer watching. It's incredible how much inflammation is a foundation for every one of these diseases. I'm really glad that we're touching on this today, because the more you get on top of this, the more healthy you're going to be. So I just want you to be aware of this, that it is an incredible blessing for you to get above this, because you're going to get healthier and stronger. And some of it are just qualities that we're born with. We can affect the patterns that we have within us and push them away from inflammation and build health just in terms of how we treat our body. It's amazing. So I want to spend some time talking about some other factors that are complementary to what Dr. Malou was talking about with the gut and the organisms, the bacteria, short-chain fatty acids. She was covering some amazing material, just amazing, that we don't talk to you about when you go to your doctor's office. You know, you never hear this. You're just going to hear, okay, this test didn't come out normal, and so we're going to give you this drug. But the drug doesn't cure you. It doesn't correct what isn't right. It doesn't heal you. So I love that we're able to share this kind of information with you so you can step in and work directly with God and help to restore and build yourself as God is healing you. You are literally working with the Lord. You're supporting the great healing that He's giving you through healthy lifestyle, through treating your body the right way instead of the wrong way. So I want to give some information that is complementary to Dr. Malou, just to kind of help you with a broader based approach to how you should eat, how you should, you know, choose foods, exercise, all kinds of things, because this has a direct impact on your health. So let's go again back into inflammation, but let's look at some other factors where inflammation can be a very big deal for you. And again, it's complementary to what Dr. Malou was sharing. So how many of you all know about the prostaglandin pathways within the body? Probably not very many of you, because it's not something that we talk about very much as doctors with our patients. So it's something we really should be, because these are foundational informational subjects that if you understand them, you'll know how to treat your body in a healthy way and make intelligent choices so that you get healthier and healthier, you feel better and better, you have more and more energy, and you move away from illness. So what are prostaglandins? You've all heard of hormones. Those are chemical messengers that God created within our body. We make them through our endocrine glands, our glandular system of the body. And they give, again, they're chemical messengers. They give messages to our cells, to our tissues, to our organs about how we should behave, choices we should make, good choices, bad choices. And they're crucial, these chemical messengers. They work all over our body. And we have endocrine glands in our brain, like the hypothalamus, the pituitary, pineal, and they trigger the endocrine glands of our body, like the thyroid, parathyroid, pancreas, adrenals, thymus gland of the immune system, ovaries in women, testes in men. So many different glands, all making hormones, chemical messengers that affect everything that your body does. Well, you have other chemicals that work in a little different way that are also like hormones. And these are called prostaglandins. And they're more short-lived, and they're made locally. The other hormones, the regular ones like a thyroid hormone or an adrenal hormone, they pass from the gland into the bloodstream and they can be dispersed all over the body. But the prostaglandins are more localized and they have very dramatic, strong effects on our body, including inflammation. So I want to share with you that we have several different kinds of prostaglandin chemicals or hormones. Some of the pathways with prostaglandin lead you towards inflammation. They actually make you have inflammation. It's not what we want. And some of the pathways take you away from inflammation. The chemicals actually protect you from inflammation. Now, of course, we want to move away from the pro-inflammatory pathways that are going to make you sick, give you the colds, give you the flus, give you the liver disease, give you kidney disease, give you cancer. I mean, just on and on and on. So we want to lead you away from that and toward those things that protect you. So diet can play a huge role in this. I love what Dr. Malou was talking about earlier, and I want to share with you that some of the same foods that she was talking about work through the prostaglandin pathway as well. So all the foods that we know are common allergens, and these are things like, they're very common foods, they're standard American diet. Sugar, dairy products. When I say dairy, it doesn't matter if it's butter or ice cream or milk or yogurt or cheese or all of your favorite dairy products. They contain fats and proteins that are inflammatory. Same thing with wheat and rye and barley, those gluten-containing grains. They are inflammatory for many of us. Soy is inflammatory for many people. Even foods like tomatoes and strawberries, depending on the person, there's a lot of foods that can be more commonly inflammatory. Peanuts. I see a lot of that with kids. We know kids can have very serious inflammatory reactions to peanuts. So we want to be very careful eating a lot of those foods that are inflammatory, and we want to put you toward foods that, for the most part, because you could be allergic just to lettuce leaves. You know, there are some people way out there on the edge that are allergic to foods that nobody else is. But for the most part, we want you to be using foods that are high in nutrients, high in vitamins, high in minerals, and that have more of a protective effect on your body. That would be lots of fresh vegetables, whether they're leafy greens or root vegetables or the broccoli, cauliflower kind of family vegetables, squashes. A lot of the vegetables are very good for you. Now, there's some people that do react, like to tomatoes, eggplant, you know, the nightshade kind of family of plants, or get gas with broccoli or cauliflower. So there are people that react to different class of vegetables. But on the whole, these are very well tolerated and they're good for your body. A moderate amount of fruit is a wonderful thing in your diet because it can be high in minerals like potassium, vitamin C. Some of the fruit have fiber, but more moderate amount because of all the sugar in fruit as well. Whole grains that are preferably organic, like brown rice, millet, quinoa, rather than those grains that are refined, like refined wheat or wheat in general. We want to be very careful with those and not eat so much of those because they're allergenic, they're inflammatory, they're going to make you more sick. Beans and peas, raw seeds and nuts, eggs, and of course for those of you that like meat and you're not a vegan or vegetarian, free-range or organic poultry, omega-3 rich fish, those are the ones to be eating. Those tend to be more anti-inflammatory, they're more protective. Alcohol, you have to be very careful with. It's very inflammatory. It can be harmful for your liver, your heart, and your brain. It's very aging to the body to drink a lot of alcohol. Eating a lot of sugar, same thing, it's very inflammatory. And it's terrible for your pancreas, for pushing you more toward diabetes or blood sugar imbalances. Coffee, again, in small to moderate amounts, it's good. People have their cup or two of coffee in the morning to get themselves going, get the little caffeine hit, and that's fine. There isn't really much issue with that unless you have a specific intolerance for coffee and caffeine. But you take 10 cups of coffee a day, 15 cups, 12 cups, 8 cups, like some of my medical patients have, and you can start getting sick. Everything's a matter of proportion, good judgment, eating the right amount and not eating amounts that would make you sick. In my medical practice, I would have patients come in who love cookies. They love Oreo cookies, they love chocolate chips, and they would come in to me and look really embarrassed and feeling really ashamed of themselves, and they'd say, I was just gonna eat one Oreo cookie, and they end up eating the whole package. Or they end up eating two packages, and they were just going to eat one chocolate chip cookie, and they go, oh, I ate the whole thing. And see, that's an overload. That's where you really are creating inflammation in the body. It's way too much sugar. So you have to be careful. Everything is moderation, and then you're eating well, you're eating safely. So I wanted to make that point. Those prostaglandins that are bad for your body, that make you be inflamed, are called series 2 prostaglandins. And again, they come off of eating a lot of cheese or ice cream or wheat or sugar or alcohol or any of these foods that are very inflammatory. And what happens? The part of the body that is over making series 2 prostaglandins, you get swelling, you get redness, you get pain, you get spasm of the muscles, the circulation, the blood flow to that part of the body is altered. You can even get scarring, fibrosis. Inflammation, once you start getting it, is chronic. It can keep coming back and coming back. That's why your dietary choices are so important. And on the other hand, we have the series 3 prostaglandins, meats like salmon and tuna fish and trout. Though they contain the omega-3 fatty acids like EPA and DHA that form the prostaglandins that are series 3 that are good for your body. They're anti-inflammatory. They feed your brain, they feed your eyes, they feed your hormones. They're good for your heart, they're good for your blood pressure, they're good for your mood. They help your mind even. So these are very beneficial. And the vegetarian sources of these come from things like flax seeds and chia seeds. Those are vegetarian omega-3s, alpha-linolenic acid. And those are good kinds of omega-3s. And you can eat all of these and you'll feel your best. It's a great thing to be doing. So I really want to encourage you, just by sharing a little bit about the prostaglandin pathway alone, how much through diet you're either pushing yourself towards inflammation and every kind of sickness there is, or away from inflammation where you get more and more healthy, more strong, more sharp, more energy. Resistance to illness gets stronger and stronger. Like, what could be better? So I just love you guys, and it's so wonderful to share with you. And I love doing this. We want you to be your healthiest and your best. Please send us your questions. Please send us your concerns. In Jesus' name, may you all be blessed with God's love and our love too. Amen.